red corner, make some noise for Thomas Black.
So our second contest of the evening, a WRSA English national title. I'm excited about this one, Dale. We've got Tom Black, who's the Southern Area champion, against Zain Amer, who's the Midland Area champion. So these boys are doing it the right way, similar to yourself, through your career. You know, every step of the level, every step of titles on the way through.
Definitely. Baby steps. Pick up your lessons as you go along. Both lads got in confident, though.
Yeah, they're both very talented operators. This 5 1.5 minute rounds. Meet each other centre.
Sharp start, straight in.
Yeah, we've seen Zain, obviously, from the USKA gym, Kazim Beg's gym. He's got excellent range perception, Zain has. In and out of range, he's lovely. But facing Tom, southpaw.
Yeah, southpaw doesn't seem to phase them either. There's not like a settling in period, he's obviously.
That could be a blessing and a curse against someone like Zain because he's got an excellent right hand and right leg. Yeah, good work there from Zain, finishing with the kick. Nice and patient on the outside.
Yeah, you got that right leg.
Tom's just looking for his openings. Right hand lead.
Zain looks so comfy in there as well. Just the little ring craft. Look, position of the hands just looks really comfy.
Yeah, unusual for a fighter so young to have that composure.
Yeah.
Everything seems to be measured with him. He's not fighting just on instinct. Mixing up the level switches on the body shots there. Oh, great work from Zain. Even on the turn. Yeah, Tom's had a good look at him in that first round. What adjustments can he make now, Dale? What would your advice be to Tom in the corner after that first round, which we think has gone to Zain?
I mean, he's taken a step. He's walking onto everything for a start. I mean, what's coming at him is hard to steer away from, but he's walking into it. And he needs to take a step back, realise that there's more than one direction you can go in the fight. And pick his entrance from there as opposed to walking through everything.
Well, you get Tom as well. He's a very patient fighter. I've seen Tom fight before. He's not an aggressive, all-out pressure fighter. So it looks to me at the minute like he's waiting for the gaps, but Zain's not presenting those gaps, is he?
He's showing his experience. He's gone in with the 5 rounds in his head. It's not a 3-round fight. There's 5 rounds to go through.
And they've both been 5 rounds before, so it's not the first time that they've been in this territory. Let's see if Chris has given him any advice in the corner now that he can turn the tide in this second round. Nice side kick there from Zain. Just angle switching. It was all round kicks in the first round.
He's showing stepping back a little bit more now. He's slowed down that forward motion.
Yeah, Tom just wants to be careful that he doesn't get outworked and then it's an uphill battle on the scorecards.
Yeah, 100%. Zane's pace when he starts landing. It's going to be hard to match.
I think what impresses me most about Zain is he's as comfortable on the back foot as he is on the front foot. He doesn't feel like he needs to go forward for every second of every round to win it, which is unusual for a young lad.
He's oozing, I love this, he's oozing confidence. Just little things, just a little flick of the glove after he's landed it. But then when you're coming up through a gym like USKA and you've got experienced fighters above you to look up to, like Kaz for example, it makes all the difference to have that in your gym to look up to. You have to look outside your gym, it's there in front of
the inspiration's
teaching.
There, yeah. Isn't it? Yeah. And he's a good listener, he's a good student, Zain is. Like, he takes on board instruction well. And he's really going through the gears here, showing lots of different skill set.
The pace hasn't dropped, the fitness is great as well. The pace just hasn't dropped. I know we're only two rounds in, but it's still a good pace. We had this discussion in the gym the other day, and he's like, what would you have, talent or hard work? And hard work every day, but if you've got both, a talented fighter that will work hard, it's brilliant.
Well, I think that's the thing. I mean, it's a bit of a cliche, talent or hard work. To get to the top, you've got to have both, haven't you?
Yeah.
And then some, you've got to have that X factor as well.
Yeah. And I think when you've got a fighter that just is not talented, just doesn't get it, but works like a dog, it's heartbreaking. But then it's frustrating to see someone that has got bags of talent but just can't be asked to break a sweat.
But then sometimes you get somebody that, you know, they work really, really hard and it just doesn't come together, and then one day it clicks.
Yeah, I get you.
You know, perseverance obviously is a great thing.
Yeah, patience.
I think Tom's looks a little bit more assertive in this round. He's taking the centre. He's got Zain backed up to the rope.
If he's going to turn the tables, it's got to be this round. It's a halfway point.
Oh, lovely. Jump turning side kick from as soon as a gap appeared there from Zain. And again, that's kind of negated the good start of the round that Tom's had.
Oh, a little Superman shuffle.
Yeah, really good performance from Zain so far. Again, just short from Tom.
Yeah, I think Tom's just a little too cautious at the minute.
And he's got good reason to be, because any time he has committed, he's got hit on the counter-attack as well, hasn't he?
Yeah, I'd be cautious if Zain was punching me in the face as well.
Lovely shot there from Tom, though. Left-hand lead. But again, Zain takes away the play with the face kick. Oh, lovely variation on his work, throwing that right uppercut. But I like Tom's posture in this round. Zain hasn't broken his heart, has he?
No, not at all, no. He's still there and he's still looking for a way to get back into the fight.
And that can have his effect on Zain as well, when he's been in the ascendancy, he's done all the good work, but you've got a fighter in front of you that seems to be getting more confident.
Yep,
even there. Though he's losing, he's getting more confident as he's going along. I think that was Tom's best round.
I do.
Still might have been enough to get it on the scorecards, but
he's got a big deficit to make up for, yeah. That's the problem.
But again, Dale, as we've seen time and time again in this sport and other sports, you can never second guess the judges, can you?
No, never.
I love Tom's eyes in the corner. His eyes are fixated on his coach, Chris West, taking on board all the instructions, getting his deep breaths. Very responsive to Chris's instructions there in the corner. I like that.
He chose to stand up as well. Amazing how many fighters vary on that, stand up or sit down.
I think, again, it's a preference thing, yeah. Isn't it? Whatever works for you.
I like to sit down.
Yeah, but you're old, Dale.
I've always liked to sit down.
Yeah, myself as well, yeah. sit down, stand up, but don't lie down.
Yeah, that's it, that's it.
Again, nice kick there from Tom. Zain responding well to Kaz's instruction in the corner. Attempted foot sweep, but he got punished with a left hook on Tom. Tom's work is getting better as he's going along here.
Great little exchange there with finishing a body kick.
Again, Zain just sitting on that rope. Is he waiting for the counter-attack? Or is he feeling the pace?
Yeah, is he sitting on the rope waiting for it, or is he being forced onto it? Because Tommy's taking the centre of the ring at the moment.
Nice straight right lead there by Zain. And again, met with the kick by Tom.
No emotion on Zane's face. There's no showboating and there's no sort of desperation. It's just one.
Yeah, it's very businesslike, isn't it?
Yeah, very.
And a nice finish there by Tom as well.
Good strong finish.
Again, I think the third round was a better round for Tom. Probably didn't get it on the scorecards, but that fourth round I think was up for grabs. I think they both had their moments.
Yeah. Depends what the judges are looking for. Simple as that.
I've always said if you fight on the back foot, you've got to do it convincingly. You know, a punch coming forward is worth two punches going back.
Yeah.
We've got one round left to go here. What would your instructions be to both corners at this point, Dale?
I don't think Tom's got anything to lose in this one. He's just got to give it his all in this round. But I don't think, looking at Zain, I'm guessing his nature. I can't see him taking a step off the gas.
And again, Zain holding the centre a little bit more in this round. If Tom was expecting Zain to give up the ground like he did in the last round, that would be a shock to his system. Zain holding the centre and moving first. This is a good tactic. And you see, he was thinking about the jump turning side kick there again.
There's just not the same sting in the shots from Tom as there is from Zain. It's more of a push than a sharp sting.
And again, what I like about Tom as well is when Zain does fall short or miss with a target, Tom straight back with a counter.
Yeah, good pressure fighter.
Makes you think about missing, doesn't it?
Yeah,
if you're not getting punished for missing, you're going to keep going. I'd like to see a little bit of variety now in Zane's work. Maybe look for the head kick.
Just to seal the deal.
That's it. Turning side kick again there from Zain, backing his man up. Body shots from Tom, body kick from Tom.
Nice body shot.
Last 10 seconds. Oh!
That might be the seal that you were looking for.
And that's the one. And he took the count in the last 10 seconds. What a shame.
Still keen to go on though.
That caught him unawares, that turning side kick. And I think that's just sealed the deal for Zain, hasn't it? I don't think the decision was in doubt, but...
Yeah. That was it. He wasn't overconfident that he'd got it in the bag. He went out and as if it was still the first round.
Yeah, great work from both young lads. And a worthy WRSA English title fight there. Yeah.
This is what I like. You never not see this, especially with the younger fighters. Going over shaking hands.
Yeah, I think they both appreciate each other's efforts as well, don't they?
Yeah.
And for a junior bout, kids so young, I think Zain 12, Tom 13. I think, there was a lot of skill on show there today.
Yeah, a really, really mature performance for lads that age.
Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for both of these young fighters once again. soon after five rounds. Your new WRSA English champion in the blue corner.
So no surprises there, Zain gets the decision. But again, credit to Tom, putting a great account of himself there. And they've both got a bright future ahead of them in the sport.
100%.
Ladies and gentlemen, the new owner of the BMW, LP62FLA, you're going 5 seconds away from hitting part 01. So can you please move it? So that's LP62.